Hello and welcome to this video in which one we will try to explain about our experiment Fine-Tune in the Fiesta IoT platform. As you probably already know, our experiment Fine-Tune is about fine-grained air quality sensors calibration. Right now in our company, Hopo Ubiquitous, that is one of our most important interests. This device that you can see here is our smart spot, that is our main product in Hopo Ubiquitous. It's a device that can do many things, as you can see in this image below. But the main functionality regarding to this experiment is about air quality sensors that you can see here. The air quality sensors are there to monitor the nocive gases that we can see, we can feel in our environment, such as NO2, SO2, CO and O3. Gas sensor calibration in order to get good measurements is a tricky thing. That is because we thought about to use the Fiesta IoT platform. The Fiesta IoT platform provides data about IoT deployments, such as Smart Santander IoT deployment and the Crit One. For example, the Smart Santander testbed has a really wide deployment about gas sensors in the city of Santander. Sensors that are monitoring these parameters that we have here and we want to study. As we said before, the gases and temperature and humidity. But it doesn't make sense if we analyze that in different locations. That's because we are taking into account the location of Jet2. But how to obtain all that data coming from different deployments in an easy way? That's because we are using Fiesta IoT. Fiesta IoT provides a really good API to do that. Using the Fiesta IoT SparkQL API, we have confirmed our own request that you can see in this image over here. And in order to get the data that we have explained about that we want. Using SparkQL queries in the Fiesta IoT platform, we only found one problem. The problem is that with one query, you can only retrieve data coming from the latest measures. That's because the Fiesta IoT platform provides a way to specify the interval of time in which one you want your data. In such way, you only have to add two parameters to the HTTP request that are the from and to parameters in order to have a close interval in which one you want your data. Combining that with a script that can modify the parameters, now we can have an automatic program that can retrieve all the data that we want. Once that we have all the data in our system, that raw data needs to be processed in order to be analyzed in such softwares as R and Weka. Mainly, what we had to do before analyze any value was to eliminate or lay in values and formatting the values, the data, in order to be able to analyze that. After the data processing algorithms, we started to see some lacks of quality between the datasets that we obtained. For example, most of the gas sensor values coming from the Smart Santander testbed were too high. In any case, we started with our analysis. In order to find some correlations between the gas sensors values and the temperature humidity, taking into account also the location. In order to perform the correlation study, we used the Pearson correlation index. That is a correlation measurement that comes from -1 to +1. If the result of the Pearson correlation index between two values is closer to +1, that means that the correlation is positive between them. That means, again, that if one of the values rises, the other rises too. And in the opposite, if the correlation is closer to -1, that means the opposite, let's see, if one of the values go high, the other go down. But if the index is closer to 0, that means that there is no correlation at all, between those two values. In such way, when we perform the correlation study between all the values that we have had from the Fiesta IoT platform coming from the Smart Santander testbed, we didn't find correlation at all. All the indices were really close to zero. The conclusion that we can have from that is that the quality of the values is really low. That's because the gas sensors and the different sensors of the IoT devices that are in the Smart Santander deployment is getting low. The quality is getting really low because the deployment maybe is a little bit old. And all the sensors need some maintenance. But we weren't really sure about that conclusion. We needed to know more. That's because we started to search for another deployment, a smaller one, that was closer to us. For example, we found a meteorologic station here in Alcantarilla, next to Murcia. And we started to see if they had open data. Unfortunately, they had. And we started to get every data about those values that we wanted from that. Meteorological station. For our surprise, there was a correlation between the values coming from the Alcantarilla meteorological station, as you can see in the next table that we present here. We also have explained all of this in the document that we have submitted in the deliverable. Such a way, taking a look to the correlation index coming from the meteorological station in Alcantarilla and the Smart Santander IoT deployment, we can have as a conclusion that we already know how to determine if a value is too high or how to determine if a sensor is not really well calibrated or even broken. As a summary, we can think that this experiment has been really satisfactory because right now we have a deeper knowledge and a better know-how about gas sensors. And in the end, we have a better knowledge about sensor calibrations, about which value we could expect from gas sensors, comparing them between the temperature and humidity, taking into account at least the location as well.